love cooking but want to stay healthy, why not try the Sassy Spoon? The book has dozens of delicious and easy meatless meals. And today, author Jennifer Cola Erickel is here with more. I love your book because it has so many different ideas. You really made this type of cooking different. Tell me about that.
Yes, thank you, Destry. Basically, this is something that comes naturally to me, and what has happened is I have over the years had people who have really enjoyed the vegetarian food and eating, but didn't quite know how to approach it, and actually couldn't believe there was no meat in these very substantive meals and tasty, non-boring meals. So what's different about this and why what the book is all about is it's a very easy approach to incorporating vegetarian healthy meals into your lifestyle, whether you're a meat eater or not.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, because these are dishes I would want my kids to try, you know, too. And that's the point. You have to make them fun and interesting. So what are you making right here?
Right, and easy when you're talking about kids
easy
and a family.
Me.
Exactly. Well, what the featured dish is lightly curried. This is the complete meal, and this is what I'm in process cooking. Lightly curried peppers, onion, and carrots with some delicious fresh broccoli in there as well. And what we do first is we saute these beautiful fresh vegetables in some olive oil and garlic. Add broccoli towards the end because we want these veggies to get a little softer. And with these are all the ingredients right here that go into this presentation. Now this is it.
So let's go over some of those ingredients.
Sure.
Tell me what kind, you know, because these are kind of your secrets here.
They are, and actually they're very easy to find. That's one thing about the Sassy Spoon is there are no very
ingredients that you have to order online
or go to special stores for. These are all available in grocery stores or Costco. Probably the most unique ingredients here are light coconut milk from Trader Joe's.
And why is that important to have this light coconut?
Well, versus full coconut milk, there's a lot less fat in the light coconut milk. And it really adds something unique to just plain vegetables. What I'm trying to do with these recipes is make them exciting and interesting and not taste like vegetarian meals.
Okay, and what is this?
This is my choice for some sort of a teriyaki based. This is actually a gluten-free one, but really as the cookbook will often suggest, very easy to find ingredients, but you can substitute your own flair with things.
Of course.
Olive oil, of course.
And then this is important because this is a big ingredient here and becoming more and more popular. Tell me about it.
Yes, quinoa, which if you can pronounce it, you're ahead of half the population already. believe it or not, Costco even carries this now, but quinoa is an ancient grain that's very high in protein, and it's basically what I use instead of rice or any other grain anymore.
Okay, good grain, high in protein. And then what is this here?
This is liquid aminos. Actually, the recipes that call for low-sodium soy sauce, this is actually what I use to substitute, and I encourage in the cookbook. Again, you don't have to use this, but you're adding more nutrients with liquid aminos versus just a soy sauce. And then for a little sass in the recipe here, a little sassification, I've got some chili paste that I've added as well.
Now, what advice would you give someone if they're worried their family, you know, I don't know if my family's going to try that.
Right. I hear that a lot, and what's interesting is you can stack these recipes. In other words, you make the main meal here, and then you can incorporate some broiled chicken or barbecued lean meat in addition to this. But really what I would suggest is whatever you're going to do, try one or two major changes, nothing more.
Yeah.
In other words, just incorporate it so people don't feel, your family doesn't feel like you're doing a drastic change with their diet, with their dinner time, with their lunch time. And it's not just about meals. I've also brought here Destry.
This looks so good.
This is an appetizer. I mean, even when you're entertaining friends, you can incorporate a vegetarian diet without meat. These are sweet potato, red onion quesadillas, and they are absolutely delicious.
Oh, yeah.
And people, I usually run out of those before anything
really
else.
Really fast.
Yes, exactly.
Well, it looks really good. You have dozens of more recipes, of course, in the book. The book is called The Sassy Spoon. And for more information, all you have to do is go to sassyspoon.com. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Destry.
Good to